Welcome to the video lecture series on Communication Theory and Techniques, Unit Number 5. In the last class, we have seen interpolation formula. In today's lecture, we will go through a few of the numericals on sampling. Here, few of the formulas are listed, which will help us in solving the numericals. Nyquist rate is given by fs is equals to 2 times the highest necessary signal frequency. Sampling period is ts, which is 1 by fs, and fs is 2 times of highest necessary signal frequency. Similarly, if they give you in the angular frequency form omega, you can write it as 2 by fm, and you can get fm, which is omega by 2 pi. Similarly, if the given expression is in the form of cos A into cos B, convert it using this formula. And we have already seen in the interpolation formula, sinc theta is sin pi theta divided by pi theta. Sinc square theta is sin square pi theta divided by pi theta whole square. And sin square theta is 1 minus cos 2 theta divided by 2. Here, any message signal, if it is given and if they ask you to represent in the frequency domain and plot the spectrum, so we need to take Fourier transform. So if a signal is given which is in the cos form, so if you take the Fourier transform for a cos signal, you will get AC by 2 delta of F minus F plus delta of F plus FC. Similarly, if the given numerical has sine term, if you take the Fourier transform for a sine component, you will get AC by 2J delta of F minus FC plus delta of F plus FC. Let's see the numerical number 1. Here, it is given that an analog signal is expressed by the equation which is given as x of t 3 cos 50 pi t plus 10 sin 300 pi t plus cos 100 pi t. And we are asked to find Nyquist rate and Nyquist interval. We know Nyquist rate is fs is equals to 2 times the highest necessary signal frequency, and ts is 1 by fs. Let's see how to do this. First step, you write down the given problem statement expression. Next, you can see here, you can convert this in, this is an angular frequency, so you can write 3 cos omega 1t plus 10 sin omega 2t plus omega 3t. So omega 1, if you compare with this, it is 50 pi t. Omega t, 2t, if you compare with this expression, it is 300 pi t. Omega 3t, if you compare with this, you will get 100 pi t. So that is what we have done here. So omega 1 is 50 pi, omega 2 is 300 pi, and omega 3 is 100 pi. So from this we can get F1, which is 50 pi divided by 2, which will give us 20 pi hertz. Similarly, F2 is 150 hertz and F3 is 50 hertz. Now, in order to find Nyquist rate, which is 2 times the highest message signal frequency, but here we have total 3 different message frequencies, F1, F2 and F3. Now the question may arise, what should be our FM? As I told you repeatedly in the previous lecture, my FM is the highest message signal frequency. So if you have 3 different message signals, then if you want to sample, you need to consider the highest message signal frequency. In this case, if you observe F2, which is the highest message signal frequency with 150 Hz. So your FM would be maximum of F1, F2, F3. So out of these 3 frequency components, the maximum one is F2. That's why the FM will be the 150 Hz. So Nyquist rate is given by FS is equal to 2 FM, and FM is the highest message signal frequency, which we have considered in this case is 150 Hz. So substitute 2 into 150 Hz will give you 300. Next, we need to find Nyquist interval, which is TS, and TS is 1 by FS, which is given by 1 by 300 hertz, because fs is 300 hertz here. So 1 by 300 hertz will give you 3.3 milliseconds. So this is the answer for the first numerical, where we found Nyquist rate, which is 2 times fm, and Nyquist interval is 1 by fs, which is 1 by 300 hertz in this case. Now let us see problem number 2. In this case, what he has asked us to determine is Nyquist rate and the Nyquist interval for the given message signal x of t, which is 1 by 2 pi cos 4000 pi t into cos 1000 pi t. So as I told you, this is in cos A, cos B form. So first thing what we need to do is apply the cos A, cos B form, which is 1 by 2 cos A minus T plus cos A plus B. So when we apply the formula, we get 1 by 4 pi cos of 4000 pi minus 1000 pi t plus cos of 4000 pi plus 1000 pi t. So when I calculate this value, we get 3000 pi t, and when we calculate this component, we get 5000 pi t. Now we know that there are two different message signal components, which is cos 3000 pi t and cos 5000 pi t. So again, we have to follow the same procedure. We need to compare with cos omega 1 t and cos omega 2 t, which is done here. Omega 1 is 300 pi and omega 2 is 5000 pi. From this, we will get f1, which is 1500 hertz, and f2 is 2500 hertz. Now, in order to find Nyquist rate, we need to get the highest message signal frequency. So if you observe, between these two message signals, the highest frequency component is f2, which is 2500 hertz. So this will be considered for the sampling. So fm is maximum of f1 comma f2. f2 is the highest message signal frequency, which is 2500 hertz. So Nyquist rate is given by fs is equals to 2 times of fm, and fm is 2500 hertz. So we will get Nyquist rate at 5000 hertz. Next, we need to find Nyquist interval, which is given as ts is equals to 1 by fs, and 1 by fs is 5000 hertz. So substitute the value 5000 hertz. So 1 by 5000 hertz will give us 0.2 milliseconds. Now, the one question may arise here is, when I have f1 and f2, why to consider the highest message signal frequency, that is maximum of f1 and f1 comma f2? Why can't we consider the minimum value? In my previous class, when I set my sampling frequency, which is less than 2 times of highest message signal frequency, it leads to aliasing. So if you consider the minimum message signal frequency, it leads to aliasing or overlapping of the information, and due to which you cannot recover the original message signal. It leads to distortion. That's why we should always go for, so when you have f1 as 1500 hertz and f2 as 2500 hertz, if you take 1500 hertz for the sampling, it leads to aliasing. You will not be able to recover the message signal later. That's why we need to consider the highest message signal frequency, which is the Nyquist criteria. In the next lecture, we will see few more numericals based on sampling condition, representing G of F, G delta of F, and how to write the sampling equation for a particular given numerical. And based on that, we will further move to the natural sampling and flat top sampling. Later we will see sample and hold circuit. These are the concepts which I will be covering in the upcoming